Welcome to another edition of Designing Spaces, the show that's all about you and your space, your home and surroundings. I'm Debbie Murray.
And I'm David Jones. Home improvements on today's show. There, I said it.
And he means it. Mm-hmm. On today's show, we look at how you can improve your property.
Now, your home's exterior is very important to its curb appeal, so we have a couple of things to look at there. And we even get into water quality for an improved lifestyle.
Plus, we see how you can save some money while doing it yourself.
And all the handyman types will definitely want to see that.
So stick around and see it all right here on Designing Spaces.
All right, now that we've looked at some of the nuts and bolts aspects of your home.
And how you can save money.
Right, now we can turn to the more organic side of home improvement, like your water quality.
Right, which is very important to good health, and we all want a healthy home. So here's Designing Spaces correspondent John Osbeck.
Lots of homeowners these days know about the value of recycling and controlling the use of energy around your home. But did you know that water quality, and specifically the condition of your water, can also have an impact on your lifestyle and your family's health? Hard water, that's water which contains lots of minerals, can damage your home, leaving ugly calcium and magnesium deposits on surfaces like bathroom tiles and fixtures. These minerals and other irritating chemicals are left behind on your clothes when you wash them, and of course, on your skin.
Yuck.
Well, to explain more, we're in Buckeye Lake, Ohio, with an expert in water quality with us on Designing Spaces, Julie Moore from Hague Quality Water International. Julie, thanks for being with us today.
Thank you, John. Thanks for having me.
You bet. Now, a lot of people probably don't know whether or not they have hard water in their home, so how can they go about finding out about the quality of their water?
You know, people do take their water for granted, so they should have a Hague water technician come out to their home, and he would do a series of on-site tests. We just did a sample of the water in this home, and we discovered that it is hard. It's pink right now. And we took our solution. We discovered that this water really has hard water problems. It took us 30 drops. We know that there's 30 grains of hardness in this water. We would also check for the pH, the iron. If you notice a rotten egg smell in your water, we would check for the sulfur. Mm-hmm. And if you were on a city system, we would also check for your chlorine and other specific problems that you might have. So we would just run a series of tests specific for your water. You know, people don't even realize all the problems that can come from hard water. Just like, have you ever had to replace your coffee pot because the water didn't want to come out and it takes an hour just to get a pot
sure.
of coffee, so you replace the whole thing. Same thing with your shower head. If you've taken a shower and you can't get the water to come out evenly, mm-hmm. the white residue that's up there. Any water-using appliance in your home, and that includes all your plumbing fixtures. You'll see the white around your plumbing fixtures. That's all caused from hard water damage. Hard water will leave a residue on your skin. So if you've got itchy, dry skin, especially in the winter too, mm-hmm. Hard water will do that because it closes the pores.
So not only with the water that we're using for cleaning and for household appliances, but those chemicals are still in the water that we're drinking.
Right, and that's even more important. We've got the working water, which we're using for our washing our clothes and our mm-hmm. dishes, and then we've got our life support water. Now, who wants to drink water that's got nitrates and chlorine and fluorides and all these other things in it? Mm-hmm.
So we're talking about two different issues, one with the water that we use in our appliances mm-hmm. and so forth, and the water that we consume. How do we go about treating those two things?
Most people would go and get a generic unit and hope that it takes care of all their problems. So they would go out and they would get something for their dirt and sediment, and then maybe they would get something if they found out they had an iron problem, or every single problem they're going to have a different type of unit. And unless you've got room for a whole water treatment plant right next to your water heater, you probably don't want to go that route. So we suggest the Max Pack, which consists of our WaterMax. This is a smaller example of what the WaterMax mm-hmm. is. But this can be configured 83 different ways. It's a patented technology by Hague, and this will address all of the specific problems with your water. Then we also have the RO system, which will take care of all of your drinking water.
RO, now what does that stand for?
That's reverse osmosis, so it reduces by 98% the total dissolved solids in your water, and also the other things you really don't want to be drinking, like chlorine and nitrates and other chemicals that might be in there.
And reduces the amount of bottled water you probably have to buy.
That's right, so it makes it a green system because you're not going to be buying all the bottled water. How much money do you think you spend on bottled water?
Plenty.
We all do, and whoever thought we would pay for bottled water?
So with a system like this, you can actually end up saving money.
Right, not just because of the bottled water, but if you think about all the cleaning products that you use in a month, all the money that you spend, well, now you can reduce that number by 75%. So that means a lot less shampoo and soap and body gels and all of that. And then you won't even need stuff like a soap scum remover or a lime and iron, because you're going to have soft water.
Well, it looks like this family's going to be enjoying some peace of mind, not to mention some great tasting healthy water thanks to their new conditioning system. Julie, thanks for being with us
today. Thank you, John.
For Designing Spaces, I'm John Osborne.
Cheers.
Thanks, John, and cheers to you.
You know, we've covered a very large subject, home improvement. Mm-hmm. That's a subject that holds a lot of water around here.
Okay, yeah, well, that was just a drop in the bucket.
Oh, touche. Uh-huh. That was good. All right, let's just leave it at that. Say goodbye. I'm David Jones, and thanks for joining us today.
And that's Water Under the Bridge for us today. I'm Debbie Marie. We'll see you next time. I got the last one.
Wow.
For more information about anything you've seen on today's show, or to find out how to be part of the show, log on to designingspaces.tv.